I know you've all heard the phrase, you are what you eat, but how could you know what you are if you don't know what you're eating? And if you think you know, you're probably wrong. Now, if you watch this show, then you know that genetically modified foods are more prevalent than ever before. In fact, they're so widespread, they're assumed to be in over 70% of all grocery store products. Currently, all of the following crops are commercially sold as genetically modified right here in the U.S. Soy, cotton, canola, sugar beets, corn, and Hawaiian papaya, and squash. Now, for those of you who don't eat corn or soy or beets and think that you're not eating GMOs, ponder this. Soy and corn account for the base product in almost all processed foods in the U.S., and they come in the form of soy flour, protein, lecithin, corn flour, starch, or high fructose corn syrup. And as bad as all that sounds, what I'm about to tell you is just downright bizarre. You're also eating wood. Yep, you heard me right, wood. And the FDA has set no limitations on how much wood companies can put into your food. It's called cellulose. It's a virgin wood pulp that's been processed and manufactured to use in multiple products. In food, it's labeled cellulose gum or powdered cellulose. But according to Jay Rettenmeyer, USA, the main company that supplies it, these fibers are not only used to extend the shelf life of processed foods, they're also used for plastics, cleaning products, kitty litter, glue, paints, among many other things. But the company claims that adding cellulose to your food is a good source of fiber for your diet and can also reduce your fat intake. And although that may be true, it's quite disgusting to think that we're ingesting wood pulp simply because it's 30% cheaper than real food. And just to name a few companies using this wood filler: Pepsi, Kellogg's, Weight Watchers, General Mills, Sara Lee, Kraft, Dole, Nestle, and pretty much all fast food restaurants. Now, if it isn't shocking enough that you're eating wood, you might be a little startled to know that you're not eating real fruit as well. Yep, products like pancakes, cereal, yogurt with, quote, real fruit leads consumers to believe that they're getting their daily fruit intake. But the Center for Science and the Public Interest has revealed that the majority of these fruit products are just balls of sugar and soybean oil mixed with food coloring and minuscule bits of dried fruit. So, whenever you see a label that says made with real fruit, it's pretty safe to assume that you're just eating clumps of sugar. So how do these companies get away with this? Well, they just say that it's flavored either naturally or artificially, and the FDA puts the burden entirely on you. You should know what you're eating, despite the slick and misleading propaganda by these food companies on their labels. I'm talking about how a majority of processed meat in this country is treated with ammonia. Yes, a company called Beef Products Incorporated had a genius idea of how to eradicate the E. coli epidemic. Inject beef with ammonia. You know, the same chemical that's poured all over public restroom floors to kill bacteria? That stuff is more than likely to end up in your hamburger and your kid's school lunch. And sadly, while it claims to kill E. coli, it doesn't. But here's the real kicker. The FDA doesn't require ammonia treatment to be labeled on meat. Instead, it's innocuously called a processing agent on the label. Don't worry, the USDA has validated its safety based on the company's word alone. But say you might not eat red meat. What about chicken? Now, aside from the array of hormones being pumped into chickens, did you know that poultry is also being fed caffeine, the active ingredients in Tylenol and Benadryl, banned antibiotics, and even arsenic? One study in the Environmental Science and Technology Journal found that chickens are routinely being fed illegal antibiotics that breed superbugs. And they're illegal for a good reason, because antibiotic-resistant infections kill more Americans every year than AIDS, according to the Infectious Diseases Society of America. And when this was exposed, the industry claimed that Benadryl, Tylenol, and Prozac reduce the chicken's anxiety, but then they're also fed caffeine so they can be awake longer, spending more time eating and growing fatter. That makes sense, doesn't it? And last but not least, the journal Science of the Total Environment found that 9 out of 10 broiler chickens in the U.S. are fed arsenic. Yes, arsenic, a chemical element as deadly as cyanide. Look, by now I hope you've realized that these companies don't care what they're putting in our foods. And if we just mindlessly consume them, we're all just guinea pigs helping corporations get richer as we get sicker.